Well, 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 look who showed up for your daily dose of doom and gloom, sprinkled with some good news. So that's good, right? But the not so good news, if you are in commercial real estate, welcome to the gigantic, fiery dumpster of just garbage that you're probably trying to survive right now. And I don't know if there's a light at the end of the tunnel. And it looks like the bulb is currently dimming on the stock market either. So if you would like to watch full coverage of the market sell-off, which I will cover in this video, I will explain. We're going to be talking a little bit about those bonds, about those bond yields. Everyone's like, what? What's a yield? What's that? What's the Fed? Look at all of that. Oh, it's just so beautiful. Where do you live? Well, if you live in any, well, if you own any of those and it happens to be commercial, well, not so good. Purgatory grips $146 billion. That's a lot of money of distressed commercial property. The sector has $2.3 trillion of debt that is due. I wish, you know, too bad they're not the Fed, right? They're like, got debt. Hey, look, I fixed it. Delinquency rates are soaring to 20% for hotels, but there is some good news. You can actually make money out of this. See, this is how you got to be thinking. Want to own an apartment building? Buy a distressed, it's black. When it's red, that's when I have to look at it. Buy a distressed hotel for pennies on the dollar. That sounds like it might be a good idea. This guy actually is snapping up all of this bad
finding
hotel
an affordable
stuff
apartment
here.
Was hard I'll enough before you. The pandemic, right? But now things are even worse. Some are calling it a crisis. As land, labor, and material costs climb higher, builders say putting up new affordable housing has become, well, not so affordable. And that's why some apartment developers are looking at hotels. They're already built. Not many people are using them these days, and all they really need is a little bit of work. CNBC's Diana Olick on a match made in real estate heaven.
Give us Diana.
This small apartment building near Minneapolis kind of looks like a hotel. That's because it recently was one. But just before the pandemic struck, developer David Peters bought it and converted it to Town Square Place, mostly affordable apartment units with some remaining hotel rooms.
What we saw when the pandemic struck.
Okay, you're using that word too many times there, David. We are on YouTube right now where they slap your hand. They're like, I cannot say that. But that's what they're doing. David should have bought it before, though. I think he probably didn't get a very good deal on that hotel. But people are buying these hotels now, pennies on the dollar, and going like, hey, you guys want to rent a room? Now Amazon's like, oh, hey, look, a mall. I think we shall buy that said mall. Man, talk about just the change, the paradigm shifts that are happening. And you guys, when it comes to money, when it comes to assets, you got to move your assets. Got to move it. Move the assets. Say, like gold, people are like, no, I'm just going to buy and hold all gold, right? But no, if I say it's top, you may want to take some profit off and buy it at the bottom. Maybe you can buy a lot more. I'm just thinking, but malls values plunge 60% after reappraisals triggered by what? Bad debt. Landlords will be walking away from some struggling centers. And well, what's going to happen? I could probably guarantee you that Amazon's going to step in and go, look at all of those letters that just scrolled on by. They're going to go, I will buy that. And even if Amazon doesn't buy that, I don't care. How do we trade? We look, oh, look, it's down. Can you believe this? Check this out. Simon Property right here. See this right there? Simon Property down. Now, so in your head, here, I'll just in case you cannot see it, I will go ahead and I will circle it for you. We're talking right there. Just in case. Ooh, what's that? That's a dirty word. But I might tell you, oh, it's down, it's down, it's down. But do I trade it that way? No. So please, whatever you do, do not get confused by my news that I talk with my trades. And no, I have never traded this one ever, never, ever, never. And this can never be financial advice. And this is just mind-boggling to me how we are so disassociated with You know that thing, price earnings ratio, fundamentals, does a company have anything? No, which I'm going to get to. A guy named Dave started an ETF. Stick around for a second. It is just crazy. But looking at this chart, FWABAM, you know what? All the news sell, but all the charts say buy. And looking on the technicals, I'm sorry, not looking on, looking at the technicals with Simon Property Group, or if you want to pronounce it, Simon. We had a golden cross back here. I don't know. I'm just looking at the chart. Also, if this looks very confusing to you, I offer a course on it for $300. Link in the description, $700 off until it goes to $400. Just need to say that. Moving on this one, when everyone's like, oh, it's bad, stay away. Well, the stock market tells you different. I mean, from right here up to right here, you've doubled your money. But yes, on the daily, you are currently, it is flashing sell. Let me zoom in just so you guys can see it. See that? See that? Pretty strong. See that when that crosses on the MACD? You have pressure on the RSI pushing it down. I do not like that. That is not the way that I want the go-go juice. So, yeah, that probably would have been a good time to say, take some profit. Regardless of earnings, look at earnings are terrible, right? Let's take a look at the red earnings. Down 12%. Look at the earnings. Bad. That's a surprise. Bad. What's it do? It rips higher. So even if all the fundamentals, which now I'm going to jump over to Dave's ETF. Crazy, crazy things in this market. Also, I'm going to get back to, unless my ADHD leaves me, this guy, that darn government bond, and not the bond, but the yield. This is not good for stocks when people I'll be there in a moment. But talking about just throwing fundamentals right out the window where it really doesn't matter, Dave Portnoy, YouTuber, I think, he did a thing with Vlad, interviewed Vlad, posted it. I interviewed Vlad, did not post it. I'm like, no, I just, you guys... rip me a whole new one, even if I say anything. All right, so this guy comes out with an ETF, and all he's doing is just tracking, larger cap. You need to have, what was it, $4 billion. The fund, outperformed the S&P 500 by 40% in 2020, will hold stocks with a market cap over $5 billion. So as long as you can find it in Reddit and people are yapping about it, they're buying it. But also coming in from Fox, he's going to explain.
Making it look like live action TV. But here's my question. Your ETF debuts today. It's based entirely on social media chatter. Does that mean your ETF is actually going to invest in and buy the names that pop up on Reddit?
Yeah, sounds pretty good. And here you go. You see it here first. This is Trading Buzz on the daily. There you go. Where do you enter? Where do you get out? I'll tell you, never. And this is not financial. This is not financial advice. Do not listen to me. You'll lose 100% of your money. Do not jump into anything with a market order. Oh, okay. It's new. I'll buy it. Imagine Karen getting in on that buzz. Market order, what, 20 up there? And then she just happens to lose 10%. That's not so bad. 9%. Okay. Maybe you could have jumped in on a market with that. What's 10%? That's like Bitcoin's daily movements. And I think in this ETF, you got DraftKings right there. Not so much, not so good of a day today on DraftKings, but let's keep an eye out for DraftKings. Something tells me the earnings aren't too good. Surprise. Red 58%, and coming in from what is going on in all these markets? Well, we got, okay, here you go. My gold guys, go out and buy yourself some gold. There you go. If Warren's wealth tax passes, I got some billionaires that are going to be very upset with you, Warren. And I think you missed, looks like she shaved right there. Can you guys see that? Just a little section. You gotta keep going, Elizabeth. And coming in from me trying to shave, I actually do. I know you're like, you shave? Yep, let the cat just put a little milk on there. Let the cat lick it off. It's sad. When you get to the age you can finally grow something, it comes in gray. Perfect. Good job, body. I shave in the shower, and I didn't know I had the razor wrong because I blindly just shave. And I gashed like an artery. Like Johnny Bravo passes away. YouTuber dies in the shower. So what's going on in the story? What do we got? These are most popular stories. This is what you guys, most popular. I want to retire in a liberal thinking area on $3,000 a month. Come on out here to California. You can have my tent. I'm going to Texas. Let's see, bonds. What happens if I don't file my taxes? That's an easy one. You go to jail. And last but not least, fewer Americans will get a stimulus check this time around. What? What's Meet Kevin? I'm telling you, Meet Kevin's going to have a lot of angry people on his channel. And coming in from major indices. Breaking. It's red. Senate takes first step towards passing $2 trillion. Oh my gosh, man. When this thing moves into the market, yummers. We got two things. We have this coming. That's some crazy cash. TGA, right? 1.5, another trillion. What are they going to do? Let's push that into the market. Boy, oh boy. Major indices. Here we go. Not looking too hot today. We got the S&P down almost 2%. NASDAQ down almost 3%. I'm rounding. I can't even believe I'm rounding the NASDAQ. 2.5% in the dumpster. Everything, the FTSE, the Nikkei, the everything heading down. We do have some movers though, market movers in the upwards direction. And it's pretty sad when the top one is only up 7%. And I think we have some more scary things. I don't know what's scary. Me? I'm scary. Here's your bond yield. Man, look at that. But I want you guys to see some things. We have some key areas of support and resistance. Some child support and resistance. And we are in, actually, give me a second. Let me edit. Let me zoom in for you. Perfect. I think I did it. Sorry that I did not pre-do this for you. Here you go. You have support and resistance. Support turns into resistance. Resistance turns into support. You break through resistance, that now becomes support, and then you launch from there. That's a little frightening when it comes to the 10-year bond yield. The minute that thing starts moving up, the stock market's like, sell, sell. And this is how many times we touch. Look, touch once, touch twice, touch three times, and gone. Here we go. We actually broke through that. This actually may act as support or if Steven Van Meter has his way, if you guys are interested in bonds, I don't know if he said this. This is just me being a chart guy. This is what you're going to see. You're going to see it come up, hit that, and back down. So we will see who is right and who is wrong. I am a swing trader. I like little movements. I understand macro, so I get it. I understand macro, I teach macro, I do macro, I just don't really trade macro. Being a trader takes a lot more work than being an investor. An investor, you're just like, just buy and hold, whatevs. But I can't do that, especially with an audience this size, where I'm just like, you know what, I promise you GoPro will go back up to all-time highs. It just will. I promise you Lemonade, whatever, you know, the YouTubers are spouting right now, without any of this, without any technical, and then they'll learn it, and all their channels will end up being like technicals. But even when I pull back rather than pull out with six kids, game not strong. Look at that. Look, see this line that I drew? It actually has a lot more touches than that. You got to be careful. Keep your hands free. But look, this acted as a lot of resport. What the heck is my English doing today? Back to what, 2011? This area, support, lived on this support. Huh? What are the chances that we may head on down and Steven Van Meter takes the prize where this thing, let me show you something else. We are so overextended, not as overextended here on the MACD, but Yeah, we're pretty far up there. Watch when this thing reverses and comes down. Do you see how everything reverses to the means? You have everyone and their mother on the one side, and when this switches, then the bond king will be able to, you know, reign in glory. But also, if you were to pull back and look at how we are as an economy, it's horrible. How can the mainstream media say everything is okay when we almost have $30 trillion in debt? I know it's money, but it's debt. Whatever. And then we have this. The only thing that's keeping this whole system afloat is what? Well, it is debt. It's just printing more and more and more. More bonds, these things. More debt. Just more bonds. That's it. Keep it coming. And look at these charts. This is horrible. If you were to go back and look, this was kind of normal back then. And then you're like, well, I see it declining. But what you're missing, let me show you another way of looking at this chart. Let me get rid of myself. Would you say that this right here is good or bad? Do you see this? Like, this is where we were. You know, okay, that's pretty bad. And then it got bad. And now look at us. This is where we're at right now. And they're saying that we are just a roaring economy. Yeah, on stimulus. And I would say you remove the stimulus, market's gone. Everything's gone. It is all gone. And I have people coming on this channel that'll say 80%. That's basically what you would lose in the housing market. That's what you would lose in the stock market. It would just all go to kaput. So they will constantly have to print more debt, like you see here. That's it. They just keep going. Now, here's the problem. Because it's just debt. Remember, these are just debt. That's it. Just debt notes. This here, I know, for my gold lovers, this is real money. That's gold. Get it? That's money. This is not money. This is just debt. This is pieces of paper. These are bonds. These are baby bonds. Is that you here, see what you have to pay back in your taxes? Every time they do that, the more hours of the day that you have to work. Every day, more trabajar. Until you figure it out, which I've been teaching since forever in the high school for free, is start a business and trade equities. Ta-da! And also, I need to apologize to my students that are in the course. When stuff you see come up on the screen, sometimes are my students' products that they're like, Bravo, I didn't want competition, man. And for that, I am sorry. Also, what my wife buys on Amazon, trash bags. Oh my gosh, there's so much money to be made in trash bags. It's just shocking. When she buys things, I'm like, wait, how much do they make? So what? How can I make that in China? I'm sorry. Have trash bags manufactured in the United States. Let's see. I've never looked at this product ever before. That looks very neat. Elite Sweets, donuts, keto, yummers. I think so. I do try to watch the waste. How much would you make if you were to sell little packages of donuts that are keto friendly? $67,000 a month, 50 on each package. This one's 60, so it was $150,000 every single month selling those little snack packs. And I also combine, if you guys are just like full blown, you know what? I need to get my life together and start a business. Not saying that it'll work. What do they say? 9 out of 10 businesses fail. I don't know, man. I do so many businesses. I start new businesses every year. Probably 3 at a minimum. And for the most part, they've done well. I haven't, probably because I haven't like gone all, you know, there hasn't been huge amounts of money that I've dumped at something and like, come on, let's let it all ride on black. Oh, green. I didn't know that the table had little green things on it. So that's kind of my mentality. I never go all in. Just enough. You know, if it goes bad, okay. But then these 9 were okay. But I'll leave a link in the description, $297 on that. My Amazon course, or you can bundle the two, the stocks. Those are the two, my favorite. Start a business, trade equities. If you're super lazy, just, and you don't have much cash, all right, then I would, not financial advice, I just swing trade, boop, boop, boop. Just paper trade though, don't want you to lose any money. And then at the end, you're like, I made so much money, but it was virtual. And believe it or not, you're still going to get those same feelings when you're trading, paper trading, right click, buy, you know, sell. You're like, oh, and then you brag about it. And people are like, was it real money this time? You're like, no, but just wanted to share it with you. And talking about sharing, can you do me a huge favor if you've done nothing on this channel ever? If you can just click share, copy, it's all that I ask. And if I see you out in the community, give me a hug. I like that. And if I see you at a bar in Texas, it won't happen in California. We can't even have TVs outside in California. I'll buy you a drink. And I have spent more money buying people drinks. Oh, my gosh. My wife's like, really? Are you sure you want to say that? It's okay. But thanks for hanging out to the end, and I'll see you tomorrow.